our speaker. I guess that duty is up to me. And so, we have a dynamic preacher. She's very unique in her speaking. And I love to hear, because she comes down and she speaks to you where you can understand. You can understand what, okay? So, she is the mother of two, the wife of one. She is a mother, a daughter, a wife, a friend, a cousin, an aunt, a sister. She may be an enemy, but who knows? So without further ado, I give you Sister Lenice Williams. Let's greet her with praise the Lord.
Yeah. It's about to go down.
Oh. Uh-oh. Come on. Hallelujah.
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 Once again, I forgot the word, so y'all know the Lord just... No, I got the word. I don't have the hard copy of the words. One day, I'm going to get that together. It's on the computer, on the hard drive, but not here. All right, the song. This is a Ty Trippy song for those who don't know it.
You do.
Get ready to jam.
Thank you, Jesus.
Stand out. And this song is referring to, you know, the whole armor of God and putting it on so you can be able to stand against and withstand.
Amen.
Now I'm going to call it offense and defense.
Yeah.
I'm going to break that.
Like
that's
that.
What it is.
Come on now.
To withstand.
Yeah.
Hey.
Is your defense.
Thank you, Jesus.
Stuff come against you. Oh, no, 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 no. Block that. Oh, no, 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 no. Block that. Withstand. Stand against is your offense. You come into the room, you need to change the atmosphere. That's when you stand against.
Come on now.
You're standing against
right.
The negativity, the depression. You stand against. You stand against your offense and your defense. And if you're going to be a good player in any game,
that's
you
right.
Need a little bit of both.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Now, sometimes you might be drafted because you're a good offensive player. But if you don't have no defense, you're not going to be out on the court very long.
That's right.
Or on the field very long, because you need to be good at a little bit of both.
Amen. Yes.
Right.
So we need to know that our weapons,
because right.
God is bad like that,
amen.
Are offensive weapons and defensive weapons.
Yes.
Amen.
The same weapon you can use for offense, you can use for defense.
Right.
You know, it's not like a gun. That's only an offensive weapon. You can only shoot. Pow, 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 pow. You can't block nothing with a gun. No,
that's right.
Yeah. But a sword?
Yes, sir.
It's offensive.
That's right.
And
right.
Defense.
That's right.
Yeah. You coming at me with another sword, I can put that sword up. That's defense.
That's right.
Go ahead.
That's defense.
Uh-huh.
And I can take that same sword after I defend myself and cut you asunder. That's what a stand and withstand is, your offense and defense. And as a player in here, you need to know that all of our weapons, which are spiritual, are offensive and defensive weapons.
Go ahead. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Prayer is offensive and defensive.
That's right.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
The scriptures, which is Jesus, his word is offensive and defensive.
That's right.
Amen.
Fasting is offensive and defensive.
Amen.
My flesh might be cutting up and I need to lock it down. Complaint. That's defense. And then I might go on a fast just to consecrate. That's offense. Offensive, all of our weapons can be used defensively and offensively.
Yes.
And that's what stand out is about.
Yes.
Stand out. Don't be afraid to be gods. I say it all the time. We at war.
That's right.
We at war.
Amen.
And don't take it for granted. War. You know, they ain't on the battlefield talking about what happened yesterday.
Don't tell it.
Stay vigilant. Oh, I don't need them. I just want everybody else to know to have them. Because I'm a lyrical person.
Yes.
Words mean a lot to me.
Amen.
So it's empowering if you know what the words to the song mean. You know, that's why I'm always in my own little world when it's time to praise. Because I'm listening to the words and see how they're applicable to me today. Because tomorrow they might not be applicable as they are today. Yesterday, they're always going to apply. But the difference might be grander to me tomorrow than it is today because I've gone through a trial or a tribulation.
Come on,
y'all let me know when y'all ready because I'm just rambling until y'all get set up.
But you talking some good stuff,
though. Yeah. You're doing
good. We'll jump in there.
Huh.
Thank you.
him. I thank him for being patient, kind. I want to give honor to the angel of this house, Dr. Anthony Hill, along with his wife, Dr. Yolanda.
Amen.
And the four teams in their proper places. And of course, the people of God.
Amen.
The reason the world still exists.
Amen.
So we can get it right.
That's right.
The salt of the earth. That's what the word says.
Amen.
Salt is a preservative.
That's all that
for those who don't know.
That's right.
We're preserving the earth.
That's right.
So this is youth service.
Right.
And I hope that every soldier has their sword.
Amen.
You're a pitiful soldier if you don't have a weapon. It's not a karate match. MMA. This is war. You need a weapon. And not a dirty, dusty weapon that sit on the shelf. Like I said, an unclean gun can backfire and shoot you. We're going to be reading out of the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 6, verses 9 through 12. Hopefully, I won't hold you long.
Amen.
I know y'all heard that today.
Amen.
It's good to be amongst family.
Amen.
We're going to be reading chapter 6, verses 9 through 12. I'll read aloud and I would like for you to read silently as I read. Verse 9 says, "Know ye that the unrighteousness shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revelers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you. But ye are washed, but ye are sanctified, but ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus. And by the Spirit of our God, all things are lawful unto me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any." Let us go before the Lord in prayer. Sweet Jesus, we're coming to you as humbly as we know how, knowing that your word is already blessed because it is you. Lord God, let it have no stumbling blocks. Let it be none of me, Lord Jesus, but all of you, Lord God. And let me be first partaker of this fruit and dine sufficiently, Lord Jesus, so that I may grow and come up one step closer to the measure of the stature of the fullness of you. In your mighty name, Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Like the songs we sing, the main theme is sanctified. I don't have a title. I usually have a title and a subtitle, but be sanctified. Be sanctified. Simply, be sanctified. And we know that all of us here who have the Holy Ghost, there is some sanctification. Because the word sanctification means to be dedicated, consecrated. To be dedicated means you're going to be steadfast. You're not going to change. You're not going to be wishy-washy. You're going to be consistent, dedicated. You can be dedicated to anything,
that's right,
but you need to be dedicated to God. Consecrated is to be made holy or to be set aside for holiness. You're going to be dedicated to holiness. That's what sanctified means. I'm dedicated to holiness. So all of my behavior should say that I'm dedicated to holiness. When someone sees you on Monday, they should know that that behavior or those works, as the Bible says, is dedicated to holiness.
Right,
they shouldn't
now
see you doing something in question. Is that still in church? Those works might not be dedicated for holiness. You need to be dedicated to holiness. And a lot of us, like Pastor Hill, say always talking about drinking and smoking. Well, that's the easy stuff.
Oh.
As people call them, the big sins. But them big sins, those easy to kick.
Come on.
But the inner man, that's that mind that you have to conquer, the hate,
that's
what
it wants. Right.
Loving, bitterness you got to uproot.
Yes, yes.
Sanctify yourself. We're sanctified because God sanctified us through his death and resurrection. So when you're baptized in Jesus' name, Holy Ghost filled with the evidence of speaking in tongues, you're sanctified. But it goes a little bit further than that. Because there's a sanctification in the church.
That's right.
The Bible calls it the election. Many are called, few are chosen. Will you be in the election? Will you be the church's sanctified? All of us are the world sanctified because we have the Holy Ghost. But since most of us here tonight already are saved, we're going to talk about the election. Being the church's sanctified. Are you set aside in the church? Which is hard. And the Lord took me to Pope Joshua's story. This dude is a, you know, back then they had baby mama drums. I'm gonna put it like that so we can all understand. Because these people could have multiple wives. So there was baby mama drama. And that's basically why he was hated. His father, we know the story, worked for this wife that he wanted, and he was tricked. Got another wife. Then he came and got the wife that he wanted after 14 years. And this woman happened to be barren. She couldn't produce any children. But all of a sudden, she came and she had firstborn son. That's Jacob. Not Jacob, I'm sorry. Joseph. Keep saying Jacob. Joseph. That's the firstborn of that one wife. That's why he was loved. You know, firstborn is honorable back then. Being the firstborn, and you know, firstborn man-child. You had it going on. But he was the firstborn man-child, not the oldest, because Reuben was the oldest. He was the oldest of his seed. But this was the oldest of the woman I wanted. So his father loved him.
Yes.
And his father did favorites. So that made his brothers a little envious. And the Bible said they just gave him grief, basically, all the time. That's sanctification. His father set him apart from his other brothers and sisters. His 11 brothers and sisters, his father said, I like you best. That's sanctification. And it was tough for him from the get-go. His brothers and sisters hated him. His brothers and those of us in the church.
Well,
your brothers and sisters, the Bible even says, your household.
That's right.
Those of your own household.
You better pray.
Those of your own, just like Joseph. They conspired against him. They hated him so much. One brother said, all right, let's murder him. We just gonna kill him. We'll just kill him and get me done with it. But Reuben, the firstborn, nah, don't do that, bro. Don't do that.
All right.
Don't do it. Because he knew, being the eldest, that that would hurt his daddy. Not that he didn't want to do it, too. Because we know you're the little favorite. Because the Bible say all his brothers got at him. Teased him. Hating all the time.
Yes,
from your siblings. Your flesh and blood. Sanctification. That's what we're talking about. Inside the church. Being the elect. It's going to be tough. To the flesh. But it's easy to the spirit because obedience is easy.
That's right. Now,
that's what the Bible talks about. My yoke is easy and my burden is light because it's easy to obey. Don't think, just obey. You tell some child to do something and they want to give you some lip. I didn't ask you a question. I told you what to do. Do it. That's easy. Following orders is easy. That's why his yoke is easy. It may seem difficult to the flesh. Because the flesh don't want to do it. But it's easy. Now poor Joseph, they didn't kill him. They put him in a well. Mm-hmm. Just left him in a well.
I don't like
this. Then he was sold into slavery. Sanctification, we talking about. Being being set apart. When he got an assignment, soon as he got into slavery, he was sold to Potiphar. Now, Potiphar was basically what we would call our general. You know, he was over the soldiers. He was the captain of the guard.
Yes.
As he saw Joseph's sanctification, he saw it. Hey, there's something special about that boy. He's standing out. So he got him and put him in charge. You know, the people of the world know who to come to when they need to come to. Could you pray for me? I need you. I'm in a tide. I'm in a strait. Could you pray for me? They know. And they want the blessings without the word. Blessings by association. That's what they want. Blessings by association. And my mother hit me to something a preacher said a long time ago. Have you noticed that when you go into an establishment, eat or drink, it could be empty, but on your way out, it got crowded. Where did all these blessings? By association. And that's what Potiphar saw. But even in Potiphar's house, there was some struggles. This lady at his head every day. The wife. The wifey acting up though, she at your head every day. Give me some of that. 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 And you know she got people to help her out. She the wife of Potiphar's house. She can get a maid to lay a trap. You know, it's not like she don't have any devices at her tools. She can use anything for her disposal. She can go out and get the best. Now I want you to go to the marketplace and get that cologne that he liked. All of that. All of that.
All of that.
All of that. And you know we women can lay some serious traps.
That's right.
And that's what she was doing. Daily. Daily. You wake up, what's on the agenda? Potiphar wife gonna try to holler at me. Every day. Every day that was on the agenda. Sanctification. He wasn't having it though. He wasn't having it. That's why she had to come back every day, every day, every day, every day, every day, every day, every day. But he wasn't breaking. He was standing out. I don't go for that. And she tried to rape me. I'm just putting it in modern day vernacular. She tried to rape me. And what he do? Ran. She got his clothes and he running. Because I want to stand out. I want to be sanctified. You know, they could have had an affair and nobody had to know. Running, running, running. So she even mad. Oh, no, he didn't. Who the heck do he think he is going to turn this down? That's where a man was. So she used his garments that he left, trying to save himself from being sanctified with to trap me. Twist what she tried to do into what he wanted, what he said she was going to do. He tried to rape me. Seriously? Sanctification. Now he go to jail. For something he did not even do. For something he tried to do to a boy on a daily basis. He is in jail for that. And the Bible calls the jail the dungeon, which I assume is a basement of Potiphar's house. Just imagine being sent to the basement of everything you used to control. We're talking about sanctification here. It's going to get a little difficult. It's going to get a little difficult. Prayer, wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning. Oh, Lord Jesus. We're talking about sanctification.
All right now.
It's going to be a little difficult. I told you not to talk today. Oh, Lord. That's a little difficult. But whatever your instructions are, you need to be following because you need to be sanctified. To be the elect is a tall order. Extraordinary is extraordinary. To be extraordinary, you have to do a little extra. Have to do a little bit extra. for a crime he didn't commit, but the warden saw his favor.
Come on
now. Now he in control again. Mm-hmm. But he in control in jail for something he didn't do. And these two people come into the jail. They have their dreams, and he interpreted their dreams. I'm not going to go into depth because most of us know the story. The one was killed, and the one was sent back to his position in the king's house. And he told the king, well, you know, say a little something. Maybe I can get a pardon or something. Get me up out of here, screaming for good behavior or something. Help a brother out. Come to the king for me. He had to wait for 2 years.
Yes, ma'am.
2 more years. 2 more years. We're talking about sanctification. You're going to have to go through some stuff.
That's right. That's right. That's
for sanctification.
That's right, Lord Jesus.
We all sanctified from the world, but we're talking about sanctified in the church. Being part of the election. You're going to have to go through some things. You're going to have to. Then the king, Pharaoh dreamed a dream and nobody could interpret it. He mad and heads rolling and they looking for a way to stop the death. Oh, I remember that boy that I was locked up with in cell block B. He can interpret that dream. He can do that. So they call him. Hey, hey. They clean him up, they shave him, put him in front of the king. And he interprets the dream.
Yes.
He interprets the dream. Yes. Now he's been interpreting dreams since he was 17. This is his gift. He told his family, look, this is what's going to happen. Which made them mad. We're going to serve you. His daddy even rebuked him.
Yes.
I'm going to serve, come on now. But he didn't let that go.
Thank you, Jesus.
This was his gift. And his gift made room for him. He's in front of the king, and he is telling the king, this is what's going to happen. This is how it's going to go down. Mm-hmm. And the king say, well, Dad, you got the answer. You know somebody who can get that done? He say, well, I don't know. The king was like, well, look, just stop it. We gonna get you on that assignment. You go ahead and do it since you know how you care. Handle that. And that's what happened. Now he's in charge. The king had a ceremony and everything that said, basically, you run the country. You run the country.
Yes.
I'm only above you in name. Huh?
Go ahead.
I'm only above you in name. Basically, we're equals. We're peers. You came from a jail cell to being a king.
Watch out now.
Ain't
over. Sanctification. Mm-hmm. Sanctification.
Lord have mercy.
And now you running things. You running things.
Ooh, Jesus.
But sanctification, he had to go through. And everything that he went through was for this position
yes.
now.
Yes. That's right.
For this kingship.
Yes.
He had to know how to walk amongst all kind of people.
Yes.
And he got that experience in those two places.
That's right.
Lord Jesus. Yes.
You know, in jail, you got to be with the thugs.
Lord Jesus.
Right. You know, the thugs coming in there, they done killed, they done murdered. And he know how to walk in and amongst them.
Oh, preach.
Oh, it's a low day today. Let me get over here. It's going down. It's Lucasville. You know, you have to know how to go amongst those people.
That's right.
In Potiphar's house, he was around dignitaries and people who were in the army and
yes.
all of that. He knew how to go that experience.
Uh-huh.
God know what you need for what he wants you to do.
Right.
Sanctification in the church.
Yes, yes.
That's why we should count it all joy when we fall into divers temptation.
Yes, ma'am.
Because you don't know what God is doing.
Right. Don't.
And is what you need to do what God needs you to do. To be who God wants you to be.
Yes, ma'am.
It's not folly.
You preach.
What you go through is what you're supposed to go through.
Amen.
Because it's the information you need to be sanctified for your job. That's your on-the-job training.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's right.
You need that. He needed that. And he stood out. He stood out. In every place that he went, he stood out. He was born and stood out. He was sold into slavery and stood out. He was jailed and stood out. He was set before the king and stood out. It wasn't about blending in with the crowd.
You go ahead.
I don't want to offend anybody. No, this is what I do. If you don't like it, you're going to have to remove yourself. I'm a child of the king.
That's right.
Sorry. Sanctification. Does my holiness offend you? You take it awful hard. Don't take it hard. Yeah, this ain't for everybody. I know I'm VIP. I'm VIP. I'm chosen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Right now.
Everybody want to say, except Christ is your personal Savior. Jesus ain't taking everybody.
Amen.
He might not want you, boo.
Amen.
So you just don't accept it. Like it's a check in the mail. Accept Jesus.
Come on.
He might not want you.
That's right. Say it.
That's right. Two twins in the womb. Jacob I love, Esau I hate it. Huh? What'd they do? They ain't even born yet.
That's right.
Huh? Woo. He don't want everybody.
That's why you preach tonight.
Oh, yes, you
is.
Preach. Oh, yes.
And you should be honest.
Uh-huh.
That you have the privilege of having.
That's right. Thank you, Jesus.
You should be honored.
That's right. Thank you, Jesus.
And wear it.
Mm-hmm.
Like I can't be stopped.
That's right.
No, you don't have to be proud, but you should have a spring in your step that nobody should be able to fathom.
That's right.
What in the heck? Why is she always so happy? Honey, if you only knew. If you only knew.
Real?
Man, it's so crazy. It's just so crazy. Being sanctified. We have to dedicate ourselves to holiness.
Yes.
Dedicate ourselves to holiness.
Yes, right.
Set apart.
Yes.
Be peculiar, like the Bible says.
Yes.
Peculiar people. She's so strange. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes.
That's how you should respond.
Come on, preach it.
I told my daughter the other day, let your freak flag fly.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm different and I like.
Amen.
Strange and I like.
Amen.
Because everybody can't be me.
Amen.
And when I say me, I mean the church. They can't. Handpicked. Before the foundation of the world. Handpicked. Before the foundation of the world.
Thank you, Jesus.
That means all of your characteristics and qualities God wanted. So he let the begots and 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 the begots get to you.
Amen.
Because that's what he wanted. He wanted that hair color. He wanted that nose. He wanted that anger. He knew what he was working with, and I want this particular vessel to be just like this so I can use it for this.
Thank you, Jesus.
All right now.
Thank you.
Making it plain.
That's right.
Sanctification. Know who you are and whose you are. That's our power, saints.
That's right.
That's our power. When you realize what God can do and that he lives in you, you can't be stopped.
Yes, yes.
You can't be stopped.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be stopped.
That's it.
No matter what comes your way, you can't be stopped. You might have some down days, but that's only flesh. You got to shake that real quick.
Real quick.
Real quick before you're in a bed depressed somewhere.
That's right. That's right.
When those initial thoughts come to you, you better get up and do something.
Do something.
If you got to run around the block. You know, some people say, you know, I need to take a cold shower. If that's what you need to do, you better take a cold shower.
That's right.
Because our weapons are spiritual weapons.
Yes, ma'am.
Those thoughts and feelings are spirits.
And they just creep on in and we just caress them and hold them.
Oh, yeah, wow. I know. I'm mad. Yeah. I'm angry. I'm depressed. Yeah. I'm sad.
You're not supposed to call that.
That's right.
Right. Right.
Come on, Jesus.
You're not.
Yes, ma'am.
That's how the enemy get us defeated. Mm-hmm. He's subtle. He just throw them spirits at you and they grab on.
Right.
What you gonna do with this? Oh, I'm gonna love you and make you grow and baby. No. Shake them spirits off. Use your weapons to withstand. Do some defense. Get in the box. Don't let nothing in that box. That's the sinner's job. Stay right there. Because that's how they get easy baskets. Guard the box. Nah, you ain't getting in here. No anger. No bitterness.
All right, now. Come on.
That's right.
Amen. Like defense. That's how you prepare.
Yes.
That's how you excel.
That's right.
Yes.
Don't baby the enemy stuff.
That's right.
You should be babying Jesus stuff.
That's right.
All happiness. Yeah. All peace. But instead we let that fly over. Just looking like it's a match. Tennis match.
Yes.
Start right now.
Yes.
I'm so sad. I'm so lonely. Nobody likes me.
Well, get some.
Amen.
Yes.
Get some.
Yes.
Get some peace. Get some assurance by reading your word that I'm loved.
That's right.
Get some.
Yes.
It's about what you gonna do. How does your garden grow?
Amen.
We are what we eat.
That's right.
We are what we eat.
Amen.
And if you eat bitterness and anger and negativity, that's what you're gonna be.
That's right.
That's what you're gonna be, little Mary, quite contrary. That's how your garden will grow.
I'm preaching good.
Bitterness and anger and hate. Hello, Sister Lenice. How is this heaven? Wow.
All right.
That's why. Plant some peace in that garden.
Yes, ma'am.
Go out and get that.
Yes.
Some organic long suffering.
Oh!
Have a bite of that.
Right.
Hey, come on now.
You are what you eat.
Yes,
yes.
What does your diet consist of today? What are you feeding your spirit?
Yes, ma'am.
Man should not live by bread alone, but every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. What is your diet today? Are you living on flaming hots? No nutrition. Just a bunch of empty calories. That's your diet? Flaming hots and soda.
All right now.
We need to watch our diet, saints.
Yes, yes.
Our spiritual diet.
Amen.
Everything you let in your mind will grow.
Amen.
Everything you let in your mind will grow.
Amen.
The TV you watch, the books you read,
that's right.
The posters you see, the company you keep,
that's right.
The friends you talk to, all of that is feeding your mind.
Yes, ma'am.
That's right.
Does your diet stick today? If it does, make some changes.
Uh-huh.
You can change your diet.
It may take some getting used to. That food is nasty. It don't taste like nothing because your taste buds are dead. With too much salt and too much sugar, they're dead.
Yes.
Change your diet today. It's simple. It's simple. Your right hand offend you, cut it off. That's how simple it is. Cut it off. Go down your contact list and hit delete.
Delete, delete.
Because you know that you don't know those numbers. You just look at the name and call. Hit delete. They don't mean you any good, delete.
That's right.
They're not conducive to your diet. That's what the Bible was saying. They're not expedient. You can do it, but that ain't good for you, boo-boo. It's not good at all. That friend is bringing you to hell. Cut them off. Cut them off.
Yes.
And it might happen to be some brothers and sisters in the church.
That's right.
Cut them off. Every time I see you, you got a problem with something that's going on at Bethel.
Oh,
I need to get the pink and shears. Cut them off. Cut them off. And you all know me. I don't do prayer lines for people who are saved. Because God says he's given us everything we need. Pertaining to life and godliness.
Amen.
Everything. You want something from God? Go ask him. Go pray for yourself.
That's right.
You don't need me to pray on your behalf.
Amen.
Get your relationship right.
That's right. That's right.
If it was your boyfriend, you call him on the phone. Y'all fall asleep on the phone. Now you first.
Now you first. Now you first. Now you first.
All three. One, two. He still there?
Oh, God.
We don't talk to Jesus in 2 weeks.
Uh-oh.
Right. Ooh, that's a bad relationship right there. You want it? Go get it. I'm praying for the unsaved. Those who want to be saved. Who don't have the Holy Ghost.
That's right. That's right.
Who don't have the baptism in Jesus' name. Everybody else can do their own work. Not gonna have me praying for y'all, tired tomorrow, feeling your infirmities and ailments, and you just skipping to Lou, my darling, and don't really want to be saved anyway. Not gonna work me today. But get yours. Get yours. Whatever you need, God's got it. You want some peace? You want your mind to be regulated? And what you ask him for, get some works.
Amen.
Because you can believe him for it. But he said faith without works is dead.
Yes.
Dead. You want it. You ask. Because that's what the Bible says. You ask not. You have not because you ask not.
Amen.
So you ask and then you go get it. You ask and then you go get it. Just like the children of Israel. They had to go get it. They was given the promised land, but they had to go get it.
Right now.
Get yours today. And watch your diet.
I want to talk like you.
I'm gonna be right back. Thank you.
Amen. Without further ado, I don't think there's any other announcements besides my birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Oh, your birthday.
Without further ado, let us begin. And somebody's right. All right, without further ado, may the Lord watch.
May the Lord
between
watch.
Thee.
Between me and thee.
While we are absent.
While we are absent.
One from another.
One from another.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.